Welcome back to my class again, students. So we'll be continuing with our first chapter, that is nouns, page number 7. Open your page number 7. We'll be doing now count and non-count nouns. Count means what? The word specify that which can be countable. Non-count, the words there specifies that the things which cannot be countable. Now here, nouns that can be counted, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on, are called as countable nouns or count nouns. A count noun can have a plural form. For example here, in page number 7, example, first example is given, sky. Now look at the picture, student, here. We are going to learn now what are the situations and when can we add s to a noun, when can we add es, when can we add S, ES, IES and VES? What are the situations that can we add these things? Now for example here, when can we add S? For most of the nouns, simply we add S. Now for example, B-O-Y, boy. If we want to make into a plural form, we add it as B-O-Y-S. For most of the nouns that ends in a vowel or Y, we add S. Now for example, radio, R-A-D-I-O. We add simply the S, radios. Did you get, students? Now adding ES. When can we add ES? For most of the nouns that ends with C-H, S-H, you can see here, C-H, SH, S, SS, X, Z, we can add ES. That is, example, FOX, fox. We add there FOXES. Now we can go to adding of IES. What are the situations that we can add IES? See there. Most of the nouns that ends with a consonant or Y, we can add IES. For example, here it is baby, B-A-B-Y. It is ending with Y, B-A-B-Y. We add there I, we remove wife and add there IES. That is B-A-B-I-E-S, babies. Now, what is the situation to add YES? For most of the nouns that ends with F. For example, there, leaf, L-E-A-F, leaf. That is a singular form. When we are making into plural form, we remove F and we add YES. V-E-S. That is L-E-A-V-E-S, leaves. In your textbook also it's given scarf. Now here in example 1, S-C-A-R-F, scarf, that is in singular form. I'll take this third example also, that is H-A-L-F, half. Both are ending with letter F. So I'm removing F and we are adding there V-E-S. We are making the plural form, that is scarves. S-C-A-R-V-E-S and half to plural form, that is we are removing F and we are making into plural form, that is H-A-L-V-E-S. But here berry, it's ending with Y. What should we remove? We should remove Y and add there I-E-S. Did you get, students? Now non-countable nouns, nouns that cannot be counted or called as non-countable nouns. But instead, they are measured in numbers but in quantity. But instead, they are not measured in numbers but they are measured in quantity. We use words such as kilogram, liters, meters. If you have learned in your max chapter, measurement chapter, there you will be always coming through this measurements. You have already learned about this measurements. Now for example, when you go to a shopkeeper and you tell that I want a bottle of shampoo. That bottle is just referred as liters. If you see the back side and all, you will just see the contents and all. It will be given briefly that it is so many liters, so much is the cost and all. Now if you take a tube of paint, if you are painting, you have a small tube of paint. It will be measured in milliliters, liters. You have seen that one, no? Just observe all those things when you are doing this one. Now here you can see in the picture here, X. I am just reading it as X because we can count this number of X, that is 1, 2, 3. If it is 1, I will tell egg. If it is 3, so I am telling X. Now for example, here carrots. We have 2 carrots here. I am not specifying as carrot. I can count this number of carrots, so this comes under countable noun. Now for example, uncountable noun. Now this milk, it's a bottle of milk. I can't count the milk, no? Can I count the milk? It can be measured. The quantity can be measured. But we can't count the number. So it comes under uncountable nouns. For example, here meat also. It is measured. When you go to the shopkeeper, you tell that I want 1 kg of so and so meat. You can't just count the number there. How many pieces are there in 1 kg? Can you count that? No. It can be measured. So that is uncountable nouns. Did you get the difference, students, between countable nouns and uncountable nouns? Now let us do the exercise, students. Take the right nouns to complete the sentences. Before doing this exercise, always remember that some nouns are only written in plural forms. For example, pants. We don't tell pant. We tell pants. Sheep. Water. These are such words which we always write in plural form. Now for example, first one. My brother has a red dash. You should select from that bicycle or bicycles. Here it is my brother. It is a singular form. And here it has been mentioned that a. A means always a singular form. So I will select here bicycle. The sentence is my brother has a red bicycle. Did you get, students? Next, I'll do the third one. Where are my dash? Now this is the question sentence that you are questioning. You are telling, where are my dash? Here it is specifying are. Are means it is many. Are means it is many. So you should choose here, where are my pants? Did you get, students?